world history, trying to prevent any substantial change from ever happening. Look to Romania. For once. There's something in that song that made me think,
Why?
What's happening over there?
No, if the, no, I'm not going to do that. Romania, you collective bailings, is... obviously, it was great that Obama won, but I do think it was, you know, the reason why the euphoria was so high was it mixed not only with happiness, but also with sheer relief that we got to the bullet fucking close. And that was how it came in. It was almost like I could hear a blessing go past my head. Oh, God, I've got a new appreciation for life. In Romania, they re-elected a mayor a couple of months ago, which doesn't sound that impressive, really. Until you find out that this particular mayor had died 18 months previously. That is a country not quite yet ready for change. There was a villager, she was on CNN, and she was looking straight down the camera, and she said, I know he's dead. I know he's dead. I just don't want change. And I found myself alone in my apartment in New York screaming at my own television, well, that's too bad, you fucking got changed now! He's dead! This is your country's future, not weekend at Bernie's! You can't just slap some sunglasses onto him, load him into a wheelbarrow, and take him on a spin around the news. No one notices. Everything's fine, everybody. Look, he's waving. He's waving. Person who ran against him that election. Giving a concession speech, like, really? Because I ran a fairly positive campaign, I didn't go negative with what was the obvious issue.